I think it's been a rude awakening for Patton. It's interesting because he's not rusty of all the players he's been playing international cricket. And it's just interesting. I think the main issue is, and somebody alluded to it, which is that the kind of length that he's trying to bowl perhaps are not most suited for pitches like this. So instead of, you know, really coming at the batsman, they're sort of sitting up and waiting to be hit. And it didn't help that people like Rohit and all are brilliant players in the full. You know, he literally can't, from where he stands, he can deliver that. So there's a lot of times when Pat tried to cramp them for room and Rohit and Hardik hit him off their body. And that for them is a big thing. I mean, it was somehow he tried to adjust. And I think once the pressure gets to you, once you've given away a 15, 16 run over, you're trying to make up for it, then you're always chasing the game. And when you're chasing the game, it's never.
Simon, we alluded to it already, but were his lengths closest to his wallet? Is that going to be a problem for Pat Cummins?
Well, I was trying to work it out, actually. What are we talking? We're talking about 2.2 million US, weren't we? So that's, what, $157,000, $158,000 per game. 18 deliveries tonight. $8,700 per ball. He's not really repaying the favour, is he, at the moment? Lengths were the problem. Biggest issue for him tonight was just getting that length right. In England, in Australia, where the pitches are slightly harder, you can bowl that back of a length and cramp the batsman in on the leg stump, maybe hit it into their hip, you know, and cramp them for room, because it's coming on quickly. It's not as easy to play that sort of pull shot, that swivel pull shot. On these slower type surfaces, it just sits up. It's too easy. So he's got to be prepared to be driven a little bit more, get the ball slightly fuller, more of a test match length on these particular pitches, and maybe set a field one side. When he starts to fall away, and it's what happened to him tonight, falling away a little bit and angling the ball and just continue to angle in towards leg stump, and it was just cannon fodder. So not a good outing. He will improve, he'll be better for it, but at $8,700 a ball tonight, I'd expect him to be better.
Yeah, if you bring that back to crores, Joy, for our audience, I think the economy rate he went for was very close to the number of crores. 15.3, I think he went for, and his economy was 16 today.
He was basically making about 2.5-3 lakhs a ball if he goes at this rate. I mean, that's actually the calculation you look at, 2.5-3 lakh Indian rupees a ball. I think the basic issue is, again, there was a very interesting part of it when he actually bought his field up, bought mid-on and mid-off up, and, you know, wanted to cramp the batsman up. And if you remember Rohit, I think it was Rohit who hit him over his head, hit him over the mid-on's head, it was. And immediately Kartik went up to him and said, no, push them back. You, at this point in time, the way you're bowling, you will not be able to maintain that field up. And that's interesting because, you know, it is a thing that somewhere in his head, perhaps those lengths have not adjusted. Like, Pat Cummins, though, is a very thinking, very cerebral cricketer. He'll go back, he'll see tape, he'll do this. He'll come back stronger. He's not the kind of guy, he's not a crybaby. He's very, very thoughtful about his game, spends time, analyzes it. So he'll go back, he'll look at it and say, no, I can't bowl this way. And what happens is when you first get sucked into a match, you just naturally go with what you were doing previously. He'll now have time to go back, think about it, and then very consciously do something different. But right now, this will not make pretty viewing. He's going to go back to his room and watch it. It will not be pretty viewing.